स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज अभिषेक शर्मा फ्रॉम माउंट लेटर अजीज स्कूल झांसी। टुडे वी आर टेकिंग चैप्टर 1 ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स ऑफ क्लास 12th। द नेम ऑफ चैप्टर इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू इकोनॉमिक्स। बेसिकली देयर आर फोर मॉड्यूल्स इन दिस चैप्टर। फर्स्ट इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स, सेकेंड इज डिफ्रेंशिएशन बिटवीन माइक्रो एंड मैक्रो, थर्ड इज स्कोप ऑफ मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स, and fourth is significance of macroeconomics. So the first module is introduction to macroeconomics. What is macroeconomics? As we have already discussed it in class 11th, macroeconomics is concerned with the economy as a whole or large segments of it. In macroeconomics, attention is focused on such problems as the level of unemployment, the rate of inflation, the nation's total output and other matters of economy-wide significance. The term macro is in English has its origin in the Greek term macros, which means large. Thus, macroeconomics is defined as that branch of economics which studies economic issues or economic problems at the level of an economy as a whole. Second module is our Second module is what are the difference between micro and macro economics. I have made 8 basis of difference. These are the 8 criteria on which we will distinguish between micro and macro economics. First is basis of study. Second is economic variable. Third is economic agent. Fourth, degree of aggregation. Fifth, different set of assumption. 6th, central issues. 7th, method of study. And 8th is paradox. Now, the first is basis of studies. First is basis of study. Micro studies how a consumer exercises choice of goods, whereas macro studies how the natural resources are used for the production of defense goods or consumer goods, so that the welfare of all the citizen is maximized. Second is economic variable. Micro use micro economic variables such as consumer demand or producer supply. On other hand, macroeconomics use macro variables such as aggregate demand and aggregate supply. Third, economic agents. Economic agents are refers to that individual and institution who takes economic decisions. Individuals are associated with micro and institutions are associated with macroeconomics. Fourth, degree of aggregation. In micro, there is a limited degree, whereas in macro, the degree is quite broad in terms. Fifth, different set of assumption. In my microeconomics, total output and employment are taken as a constant, while these are important variable in macroeconomics. On other hand, in macroeconomics, distribution of output income is taken as constant, while it is an important variable in microeconomics. Sixth, central issues. Allocation of resources is the central issues in microeconomics, and determination of overall level of output is the central issue of macroeconomics. Seventh, method of study. Method of study in macro is often described as general equilibrium analysis. On other hand, method of study in micro is often described as a partial equilibrium analysis. Partial equilibrium analysis refers to the condition in one market on the assumption that there is no change in the other market. General equilibrium refers to a simultaneous equilibrium in all the market in the economy. Partial equilibrium is the method of study in micro, whereas general equilibrium is the study of method in macro. Last is micro and macro paradox. What is logical at micro level may not be logical at macro level. For example, if an individual saves more, he adds to his future prosperity. If all the people in an economy saves more, एंड स्पेंड लेस, डिमांड फॉर गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज में डिक्लाइन, कॉन्सिक्वेंटली दिस में लीड टू द अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट एंड द मार्केट विल बी डिस्टर्ब. सो देयर विल बी अ कंडीशन ऑफ डिसइक्विलिब्रियम. थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स.